if you're thinking, he looks tired today, because I am. Because I was trying to have a nap last night, and then all of a sudden... Oh. Hold on. Wait. Hey, hey. I'm here. What are you doing? Yeah. What are you doing? Huh? Oh, rocket. What's that? What's that? What are you doing here? You're not Yeti. You're not Yeti. Oh, look at this. All the mud. Oh, I know. Yeti is not going to be happy with you.
And fast forward a few hours later, around 2:30 a.m., they straight up knock my tent down. I had the tent laying on me. I had to get up, get out, reset the whole tent. Because we deal with so much silliness when it comes to food and other dogs, I've had to tie it to a tree.
Good job, yes. Some water. We're going for both bowls. Desert can, get some water. Rocket. So if you're wondering where the little one went, Tan, I think she thought better of it than to come up here again. Yeti's the problem when it comes to food, so ties Yeti to a tree. Gave her food, and you know, she had a good bit, but then when Rocket here and Desert Cam finished theirs, they just bounded over, tried getting her food, put her right off, and I think she retreated after that, so it's hard. But we'll get there with her. I think, there's a little bit of bullying going on where she's the smallest. And we don't tolerate bullying. We're going to have to learn that, guys. We don't tolerate bullying. In a way, it's a good thing that she headed back down to avoid what probably would have been an inevitable incident that she would be... bullied again. So these three, you know, maybe it's because she's small. These three are all relatively the same size. Yeti's the pack leader here. She's definitely they don't mess with Yeti, and then it's gonna be Rocket, Desert Cam, Big Wimp.
To her, she's lying in wait for that kill. To everyone else, she's sleeping.
Okay, let's crack on with the video.
The only tool I have out here with me is the SOG Powerlitre. And there's a reason you always carry a multi-tool in the outdoors. This is one of those reasons. This is one of the more compact multi-tools. I'll give you a quick rundown of it.
Check it out. Got a tiny little multi-tool here. First things first, we'll check out the knife. And as you hear, it just, that click locks into place. Every tool on this multi-tool locks into place to release. Then we have this little mechanism here that you can compress. When you compress it, it just releases the tool. Alternatively, what we can do is, that's locked into place once again. If we pull out another tool, it releases that tool. But first things first, we have the knife. Nice sharp knife, no serrations. I like it, works well. Following the knife, we have the awl. Good sharp tip on it. Again, all in all is good. Next up, we have a tiny flathead screwdriver. Following that, we have a hook blade. Don't forget the corkscrew. On the other side, what we have is a pair of scissors Scissors work well. I always like to have scissors on a multi-tool. They always come in handy. Following that, we have a bottle opener. Following the bottle opener, we have the Phillips screwdriver and then a tin opener. Of course, we have the pliers. Always come in handy. The pliers actually have a wide opening, so that's nice. We also have some measurements right here running down the edges. And of course, a pocket clip.
Not my first choice of multi-tools, but it was either this or a Walther GMT. And currently, I don't need a GMT. So yeah, it is the SOG Powerlitre. And that's what we're going to be using to attempt to create a bow drill set today. So I'm looking at this little Aleppo pine right here that I'm not sure where it's come from. Has it come from here? Oh yeah, it's broken off there. I thought it just appeared here, kind of thing.
Some people say that's Bigfoot.
But I'm checking out this, seeing what I can scavenge from this. And I'm looking at this, and maybe this can be the drill.
I just want to whittle this down to create somewhat of a, just a rolling surface. And on the other end, I'm just going to create a bit of a point. Now what I've noticed is in some rocks laying around, there is little holes in them that we should be able to use as a bearing block.
That may work.
Goes in the hole. Potentially.
I think this may be just too far gone.
We'll give it a go. It may be too far gone.
So that's a bearing block, the drill, now the hearth. Naturally, in a survival situation, you want to do as little work as possible. I'm just scavenging around and I'm looking at these pieces here for our hearth, our board. It's flat, potentially. This one looks a little better. Create a little divot. That might work.
A little work. Just a little work. Now it's time to look for a bow. Okay, create a little divot to get it started. Fucking bow. So in that case, the bow was too flexible. And every time I tried to tighten it up, it was just flexing and it wasn't getting to that point where it would grip the drill in order to go both ways, only going spinning one way. So we need to find a different bow, guys, okay? A different bow. It is one that won't work out. It may be dog food later, huh? that infuriates me. Bearing block now, so reverse, what was it, the bow? And then that's the spikes, and then the drill, now the bearing blocks. Just trying something else now. Developing smoke. So an important tool the Powerlitre is missing is a saw. How we get by? Look at the tip. Look at the tip. Not good, SOG. Not good. Not all that impressed. So we've got our divot. We've cut a V-notch into it. Now we need to prep the materials for our fire.
Because it just wouldn't make all that much sense, and getting that ember and then being like, where's the wood? Where's the tinder, the kindling?
That would be something else, huh? Getting that ember, going through all that hard work and then not having the materials. Stupid.
So right now we're just developing like a bird's nest. So when we get the ember, we can pop it in there, close it up, get some air to it, whole thing goes up.
Piece of bark here to catch the ember.
With a good knife and saw, I can make one. And it's all practice, 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 practice. I'm not out here to stress. I'm out here with the dogs. I'm getting hungry. I'm getting thirsty. I need a coffee. Well, we just carry a lighter.
Oh, she's got you. Huh? Huh? The dog pack. That better.
We attempted the bow drill. It's never an easy thing to do. It's practice. You have to do it time and time again. The last time I did it, I don't know, maybe 2 years ago, maybe more. So, you know, it's upping those skills and having the Powerlitre, not great. Could it be done with it? Yeah, it could be done with it. But why struggle, huh? I'm out here, I'm gasping for a coffee. So let's just make one.
Something, that's a good feeling. It's a good feeling, guys. The old sky is back there, look a little bit threatening. So once we finished up this coffee, it's a good coffee as well, strong one. Better get to thinking about making a shelter.
So we are down to two. Two doggies. We started at four, dropped to three, now two. I think she must have left when I was making the fire. Because she was there and then she wasn't. So yeah, we're just moving now to go and set up camp because it's getting a little cloudy. And these guys, I know, you know, they're not a fan of thunderstorms or nothing like that. Yesterday we were in a thunderstorm and yeah, they were all there, not happy about it. So I'm looking for a spot here I found the other day. A really good view, but I don't know if it's
really a good spot to camp, so we'll find out. Desert camo. Yeah, this was the spot. Like this spot, desert camo. Desert camo like this spot. She loves this spot. What do you reckon, Jester? Always on the hunt. It's just to clear out some of these big old rocks.
We done cleared the biggest rocks out. I don't know why I say we, because it was just me. But, you know, they supervised. The biggest rocks cleared out. The smaller ones don't matter so much. And that's the beauty of a closed cell foam roll mat, right? It may be thin and uncomfortable, but it ain't gonna puncture.
Stairs, I reckon. That will do, Jester. That will do. Yeah, that will do. Come on. Oh, you crazy gal. Oh, nip, nip, nip. Nip, nip, nip. Don't wish you be me. Don't you nip my friend, huh? She's your friend most of the time. Out. It's the little nip she does with her front teeth. Such a small, skinny little dog. She sure is mean, huh?
She is.
Stop being mean. You just tell her off. That's all you have to do. Just tell her off. Just tell her off. That will do us for the night. Get the shelter up. Shelter's done. Shelter is done. Cuddles.
So when you talk about desert island gear, three things, three items to take on a desert island, this surely is not one of them, or not from SOG anyway. But this, yes, desert island gear.
We got quite the view tonight, huh, guys? They're admiring that view. Tis feeding time at the zoo. So what are we gonna do? Yes, oh, you're hungry. Yes, don't start. Okay, let's give old Meanie. Give me some first. Follow me. I'll lift it.
doesn't matter.
Yeah, don't worry about her. Here. Good girl.
So clearly, when it comes to the old SOG Powerlitre, I don't think, so it was, you know, in an outdoor store, for the outdoors, I don't think this is, that's not its purpose, right? Purpose is your EDC multi-tool, right? Small, compact, has a fair few things on there that are useful for you to carry around every day. It's not built for the woods, the mountains.
Plain old pasta for dinner. No salt, no butter, no nothing, huh? But what I do have in my bag is two sachets of ketchup. So why not? And give it a little mix maybe, huh? It's not nearly enough ketchup, but at least it will bring a little bit to it, huh? It still tastes like plain pasta. But it tastes good, huh? The only reason it tastes remotely good is because it's the only thing I've eaten today.
Well, that was horrible. I was just wondering where the dog went. I'll walk over here. And look at these two. Look at these two. I think we got some buddies, huh? Do you guys want some of this? Yes. You want? You want your friend to have it? You want? Okay, don't know what's happening here. Don't know what's happening here at all. Because the thing is, that Yeti doesn't share food with nobody. She's cool. She's being cool with Desert Camo. So maybe on to something. What I'm not surprised at is that neither of them wanted my pasta.
Getting a little chilly.
It'll be a long night tonight. More long nights ahead. It's not even 6 o'clock. Pitch black. Oh, winter. Kind of good for me where I just haven't been sleeping too good recently. The day before yesterday, the hunters waking me up. And then yesterday, the dogs tearing down my tent at 3 o'clock in the morning, 2:30 in the morning, whatever. And then I was up at 6. Tried to have a nap. And obviously, Rocket came and banged on the door. So yeah, maybe tonight we'll get some better sleep. But those long nights, they're just not as long, are they? No, they're not as long when you got good company. And we got some good company here. Desert Camo here, I got Yeti on this side. Yeah, we're doing all right. So for right now, this is how we're rolling. Desert Camo there. Yeti Camo there. And yeah, sandwiched. We'll catch you in the morning. Whoa, that's bright. Around 4:30 in the morning right now. To take the shelter down and wear it because it's getting cold. Need to trap that heat.
desert camera had deserted us. I figure she realizes that it's warmer down below than it is up in the mountains. The Yester's sleeping all right. She's under here somewhere. There. So yeah, more of a survival aspect to sleeping than there was the bow drill. This is but the poncho does well trapping heat, so I'm warmer now, but I'm waiting for daybreak to come, then we'll be getting out of here.
Now, before we get out of here, we want to send a shout out to Jason and Jackie for your donation on Buy Me A Coffee, and Daryl Moore for your donation on Buy Me A Coffee. We very much appreciate it. Street dogs, appreciate it. Thank you for feeding those little tummies. Collectively, without you guys' donations, we would not be able to feed as many dogs as we are feeding today. We are very grateful. If I had a coffee, cheers to you. Don't have a coffee right now, but still, cheers to you. I'm going to get a coffee. See you guys on the next one.